You literally emit light, or photons, when you die. What if I told you that right now, as you're watching this video, your body is literally glowing with an invisible light that will vanish the moment you die? Be sure to keep watching until the end of this video, because I'm going to reveal the bizarre metabolic process that makes every living cell on Earth emit light, and how scientists are using this phenomena to detect diseases before any symptoms appear. So don't click away. You won't want to miss these groundbreaking discoveries that could revolutionize how we understand life itself. Picture this. Researchers at a lab set up an ultra-sensitive camera in complete darkness, so sensitive it can detect individual photons. They place a live mouse under the lens, and something absolutely mind-blowing appears on their screen. The mouse is glowing. Not with heat, not with reflected light, but with its own biological radiance. Then comes the shocking part, the moment that mouse dies. Despite its body temperature remaining exactly the same, the glow disappears entirely. This isn't science fiction. It's a real phenomenon called ultra-weak photon emission, or UPE, and it's happening in your body right now. Every single cell in your body, from your brain neurons to your skin cells, is constantly producing tiny amounts of light in a process that's completely invisible to the naked eye. We're talking about an emission so faint that it's about 1,000 times weaker than what your eyes can detect. Yet this ghostly glow has become one of the most fascinating frontiers in modern biology. The story begins in the 1920s with a Russian scientist named Alexander Gurwitch, who was conducting what seemed like a simple experiment with onion roots. He positioned one onion root tip towards another, separating them with a piece of quartz glass. What he discovered changed everything. The receiving onion showed increased cell division compared to control onions that were blocked by opaque barriers. Gurwitch realized that something was passing through that transparent quartz, something he couldn't see, but that was definitely there. He called it mitogenic radiation, a mysterious signal that seemed to encourage cell growth. But here's where it gets really interesting. For decades, the scientific community largely dismissed Gurwitch's work. Some critics, including Nobel laureate Irving Langmuir, went so far as to label it pathological science, driven by wishful thinking. The problem wasn't that Gurwitch was wrong, it was that the technology to properly detect and measure this phenomena simply didn't exist yet. Everything changed in the 1950s with the development of photomultiplier tubes, devices so sensitive they could detect individual photons. Suddenly, scientists around the world began confirming what Gurwitch had suspected all along. Research teams in Japan, Germany, Poland, Australia, the United States, and China all started detecting this ultra-weak light emission from living organisms. The phenomenon wasn't limited to onions, it was universal. Bacteria, fungi, plants, animals, and humans all exhibited this mysterious glow. The German biophysicist Fritz Albert Popp gave this phenomenon its modern name in the 1980s, coining the term biophoton to describe these photons originating from biological systems. But what makes these emissions so special isn't just that they exist. It's what they reveal about the fundamental nature of life itself. The light we're talking about exists in a specific range of the electromagnetic spectrum, from about 200 to 100 nanometers, spanning from near ultraviolet through visible light and into the near infrared. This isn't the same as bioluminescence you see in fireflies or deep-sea creatures, which relies on specific chemical reactions involving luciferin and luciferase enzymes. UPE is something entirely different. It's the direct result of the basic metabolic processes that keep us alive. What's truly remarkable is how this discovery bridges the gap between the mystical and the scientific. For centuries, various cultures have described seeing auroras, or energy fields, around living beings. While we're not talking about anything supernatural here, the reality of UPE shows that there was perhaps a grain of truth buried in these ancient observations. Living things really do emit light, even if it's far too faint for our eyes to perceive. The technology required to detect UPE is extraordinarily sophisticated. We're talking about equipment that can pick up as few as 10 to 1,000 photons per second per square centimeter. That's roughly equivalent to detecting the light from a single candle flame from about 20 kilometers away. These ultra-sensitive cameras and photomultiplier tubes must operate in complete darkness, shielded from any external light sources that might interfere with measurements. But perhaps the most profound aspect of this discovery is what it tells us about death itself. When that mouse in the laboratory experiment died, its body temperature didn't immediately drop, yet the light emission ceased instantly. This suggests that UPE isn't simply a byproduct of warm biochemistry, but rather a signature of active living metabolism. It's as if each cell maintains its own tiny lighthouse, and when life ends, those lights go out one by one, creating a biological definition of death that's more precise than we've ever had before. Now that we understand what UPEs are and how they were discovered, let's dive into the fascinating mechanisms that make this biological light show possible. The key player in the cellular illumination isn't some exotic compound. It's actually something you've probably heard of before, reactive oxygen species, or ROS. These are the same molecules that health enthusiasts love to demonize as free radicals. But here's the twist. They're actually the star performers in your body's light production. Think of ROS as the overexcited molecules in your cell's chemistry lab. When your mitochondria, those powerhouse organelles you learned about in biology class, are working hard to produce energy through cellular respiration, they occasionally produce these highly reactive oxygen molecules. These ROS are like molecular firecrackers, bursting with energy that needs to go somewhere. When they finally calm down and return to their stable state, they release that excess energy as photons, literally creating light from life itself. The intensity of this cellular light show directly correlates with how hard your cells are working. During periods of high metabolic activity, your cells produce more ROS, which means more photon emissions. It's like having a biological dimmer switch that responds to your body's energy demands. When you're exercising, stressed, or fighting off an infection, your UPE levels spike dramatically. Conversely, during rest or meditation, the emissions dial down to a gentle glow. This connection between metabolism and light production explains why certain tissues shine brighter than others. Your brain, for instance, is an absolute beacon of biological light. Neural tissue produces some of the highest UPE readings in the human body. And it makes perfect sense when you consider that your brain consumes about 20% of your total energy, despite being only 2% of your body weight. Those neurons are constantly firing, communicating, and maintaining complex networks, all of which requires tremendous metabolic energy and produces correspondingly intense light emissions. But here's where it gets really intriguing. Your brain contains specific photoactive molecules that contribute to this light production. Non-visual opsins, the same family of proteins that help your eyes detect light, are scattered throughout neural tissue. Additionally, neurotransmitters like serotonin and dopamine have autofluorescent properties, meaning they can absorb light at one wavelength and emit it at another. Your brain isn't just thinking. It's literally glowing with the biochemical activity of consciousness itself. The timing of these emissions follows predictable patterns that mirror your body's natural rhythms. UPE levels fluctuate throughout the day in what scientists call diurnal variations, typically peaking during periods of highest metabolic activity and dropping during rest. There are also seasonal changes, with some studies showing higher emissions during certain times of the year, possibly linked to variations in oxidative stress levels caused by environmental factors like temperature and light exposure. What makes this phenomenon particularly useful for medical applications is how dramatically UPE patterns change when cells become unhealthy. Disease cells, especially cancer cells, emit significantly more light than their healthy counterparts. This isn't because cancer cells are somehow more alive, quite the opposite. Cancerous tissue produces excessive ROS due to disrupted cellular metabolism and increased oxidative stress. The result is a characteristic light signature that researchers are learning to recognize and interpret. Think about how this could revolutionize medical diagnostics. Instead of waiting for symptoms to appear or subjecting patients to invasive procedures, doctors might one day detect diseases simply by measuring the light patterns your cells emit. Early-stage cancers, which are notoriously difficult to detect, could potentially be spotted through changes in UPE signatures long before traditional screening methods would catch them. The role of hormonal fluctuations adds another layer of complexity to this biological light display. Hormones directly influence cellular metabolism, which in turn affects ROS production and photon emission. Women's UPE patterns, for example, show correlations with menstrual cycles, while stress hormones like cortisol can temporarily spike emission levels across the body. It's as if your endocrine system is conducting an invisible orchestra of light, with different hormones acting as conductors for different sections of your cellular symphony. Here's something that might blow your mind. What if the light your cells produce isn't just a byproduct of metabolism, but actually serves as a form of cellular communication? Some researchers propose that UPEs might function as biological signals, allowing cells to coordinate their activities across distances. Imagine your liver cells literally signaling to your brain cells using light, or your immune system broadcasting alerts through photon emissions. Hey guys, just a moment before we continue. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel, clicking on the notification bell and leaving us a thumbs up, so you don't miss out on our daily videos. The oxidative stress connection is particularly important for understanding aging and disease. As we get older, our cells accumulate more oxidative damage, leading to increased ROS production and higher UPE levels. This means that measuring someone's baseline UPE emissions could potentially serve as a biomarker for biological age, distinct from chronological age. Two people born in the same year might have vastly different cellular light signatures based on their lifestyle, genetics, and overall health status. What's remarkable is that this phenomenon bridges the gap between chemistry and physics in the most elegant way possible. Every emotional state, every meal you eat, every hour of sleep you get or miss, all of these experiences translate into measurable changes in the light your cells produce. You're not just a biological machine, you're a living constellation of trillions of tiny stars, each one flickering with the energy of life itself. The medical applications of this discovery are already moving from laboratory curiosities to real-world diagnostic tools. Research teams across the globe are developing non-invasive screening methods that could detect cancer, neurological disorders, and other diseases simply by analyzing the light patterns your cells emit. Imagine walking into a doctor's office, placing your hand on a specialized scanner, and within minutes having a comprehensive health assessment based on your cellular light signature. No needles, no radiation, no uncomfortable procedures, just the analysis of your body's own natural glow. Cancer detection represents perhaps the most promising immediate application. Malignant cells consistently show elevated UPE levels compared to healthy tissue, creating distinct light signatures that researchers are learning to decode. Early trials have shown remarkable success in identifying cancerous tissue in breast, lung, and skin samples using nothing more than ultra-sensitive light detection equipment. The implications are staggering. We could potentially catch cancers at their earliest stages, when they're most treatable, simply by monitoring changes in a patient's baseline light emissions over time. But the applications extend far beyond human medicine. Agricultural researchers are using UPE measurements to revolutionize crop management and food safety. Plants under stress, whether from disease, pests, or environmental factors, emit characteristic light patterns that can be detected days or even weeks before visible symptoms appear. This early warning system allows farmers to intervene precisely when and where it's needed, potentially saving entire crops from devastation. Food quality assessment has become another frontier for UPE technology. The freshness of produce, the potency of medicinal herbs, and even the detection of bacterial contamination can all be evaluated through biophoton analysis. Your next grocery store visit might involve scanning fruits and vegetables with UPE detectors to determine their optimal ripeness and nutritional value. The days of squeezing avocados and hoping for the best could become a thing of the past. The technology enabling these applications is advancing rapidly, though it still faces significant challenges. Current UPE detection requires photomultiplier tubes, charge-coupled devices, and single-photon counters, equipment that's both expensive and extremely sensitive to environmental interference. These devices must operate in complete darkness and require careful calibration to distinguish genuine biological emissions from background noise. The precision needed is extraordinary. We're talking about detecting light levels that are millions of times dimmer than what your smartphone camera can capture. Environmental monitoring represents another exciting application. Scientists are using plant UPE signatures to assess ecosystem health, detect pollution effects, and monitor the impact of climate change on vegetation. Trees stressed by air pollution, crops affected by pesticide residues, and forests responding to temperature changes all tell their stories through the light they emit. This could give us early warning systems for environmental disasters and help us understand how human activities affect the natural world at a cellular level. The controversial aspects of UPE research shouldn't be ignored. Some researchers have made claims about UPE functioning as a form of cellular communication or even connecting to consciousness itself, hypotheses that remain highly speculative and lack solid experimental evidence. The field walks a fine line between legitimate scientific inquiry and pseudoscientific speculation, which has led to skepticism from some quarters of the academic community. Current limitations in the measurement accuracy also pose challenges. UPE emissions are so faint that factors like room temperature, electromagnetic interference, and even cosmic radiation can affect readings. Standardizing measurement protocols across different laboratories and equipment types remains an ongoing challenge. The field needs more robust statistical methods and larger sample sizes to validate many of the promising preliminary findings. Despite these challenges, research is accelerating. Scientists are developing more sensitive detection methods, exploring quantum approaches to photon measurement, and creating databases of UPE signatures for different diseases and conditions. Machine learning algorithms are being trained to recognize patterns in cellular light emissions that might escape human analysis, potentially revealing diagnostic information we haven't even thought to look for yet. The future might hold applications we can barely imagine today. Could UPE monitoring become part of routine health checkups? Might we develop wearable devices that continuously track our cellular light output, alerting us to health changes before we feel any symptoms? Could we use UPE signatures to monitor the effectiveness of treatments in real time, adjusting therapies based on how our cells respond at the photon level? What's most remarkable is how this discovery reframes our understanding of life itself. We're not just biological machines processing chemicals. We're living beings that literally glow with the energy of existence. Every thought, every heartbeat, every moment of healing or growth is accompanied by its own unique pattern of light emission. In studying UPEs, we're not just advancing medical technology. We're exploring the very essence of what it means to be alive. Do you find it fascinating that your body is constantly producing light, or does it make you wonder what other invisible processes are happening inside you right now? Let me know what you think in the comments below. And if you liked the video, then you should check out this video on our end screens.